Hi folks, it's 7:37 in the morning and I am at my hometown in Trivandrum. I came home after my comprehensive, it was very hectic. Then I came home for a break. So today, good morning everyone. Today in this video I would like to talk to you about something that many people had brought up. And this is about project internships and project assistantships in IISc and IITs for that matter, and how to go about getting that and doing that. Okay, so in this regard I would like to tell you a few things. There are many caveats or riders associated with this area, and you need to understand properly exactly what you are getting into. You are getting into something that's not permanent. You should understand that first of all. This is a transition position, you can say, before you go on to do something that is permanent and much more substantial in your life. So you have to make that decision properly. Okay. So there are two things here. One is internships, and other one is project assistantship. Okay. So coming to internship, there are two things, mainly two things are there. I told you positions wise, and there is paid and unpaid internships and project assistantships. Correct. For all these things, the basic thing is that 99% of the time such positions happen very ad hoc, in an ad hoc manner. By ad hoc manner, what I mean is you need to find out professor who is working in the field of your interest, and then email the professor asking if you will be able to do an internship there or a project assistantship there. Have a conversation with the professor over many emails, and then go and meet the professor, he or she, and then finally decide on what you want to do and whether he is in a position to hire you. That is the overall process. There is no application process, or there is no selection process, written exam, interview, nothing like that. It's very ad hoc. You need to form a relationship with your professor through emails, conversations, and if you are in the same city, you have to go and meet the professor and then finally arrive at a commonly acceptable set of understanding, you can say. Okay, so now coming to the positions as such. See, there are two, in India you can say that there are two kinds of professors there. One set of professors, they are mainly focused on their PhD students, the scientific problems of their PhD students only. Okay, so their area of work will be restricted to what their PhD students are working on or what problems they have given to their PhD students to solve. So their lab will be mostly dominated by only PhD students. There might not be much support staff. Technicians who are taking care of their labs, nothing much. And these are also the professors who are not really interested in writing grants or getting project money from government agencies, and they will be able to sustain with the initial startup grant they receive to run their labs. And their PhD students are anyway paid by the MHRD scholarship. Okay. Now there are other set of professors who are extensively writing project grants, applying for projects from scientific agencies in the country like DST, Department of Science and Technology, DBT, Department of Biotechnology, SCRB, Science Education Research Board. There are a lot of agencies in the country who provide grants. The culture of writing grants, applying for project grants among IIT, IISc professors is increasing. Earlier nobody used to write such grants, but these days almost everyone is doing that, because the government has changed their policy of supporting without many riders. So government is telling that you write grants through agencies for projects, then we will support you, not just directly as a blanket support. The blanket support that the professors get are only the startup grants. So what is startup grant? That is the money that a professor gets to start off his lab when he joins the institute, whichever be the institute. So that can vary from like 10 lakhs to up to crores of rupees, depending on the what kind of work that they're doing. Okay, so when you are applying, so why I told this is that when a faculty is someone who is applying, for grants, projects under these scientific agencies, the budget head that they provide always will have some manpower included. Okay, this is unlike professors who don't apply for grants and who are working for their core only their PhD problems. These are personal interests, personal choices. They have struggled a lot to reach that position of a faculty in a reputed institute in the country. So it is their decision how they want to go about their research. Okay, so what I am telling is from the perspective of a person who wants to apply for an internship or a project assistantship. from a faculty. Okay, I'm not telling from point of view of the faculties, which none of us are capable enough or qualified enough to tell or judge. Okay, so I am telling you from the perspective of you being a candidate who wants to go do an internship or a project assistantship in IISc or IIT. Okay, so what you have to do is, because if you want to go for a paid internship or a paid project assistantship, it is better that you apply or converse with a professor who is already having projects, because these are all publicly available information. If you go to most of the professors' website, you will see the grants that they have got from the government agencies. There they even get grants from India foreign country collaborations, like India UK collaboration, India US collaboration, India Indo-French collaboration, Indo Israeli collaboration. So under all these projects, apart from the money that they have to use for project expenses, like purchase of equipment, purchase of consumables and all, they always have a budget head for manpower. So if you are good enough, you can always get hired as a manpower under these projects. This way you will get a salary also during the time you spend in that lab. So I'm just helping you out. So always prefer such professors when you are seeking internships or project assistantships. The probability of you getting remunerated through an internship position is very rare. Very rarely professors give compensations for internships, because for an internship, who is an intern? An intern is someone mostly who has not graduated his undergraduate degree and who is almost in the third year or fourth year. He has come to see how a lab in IISc or IIT looks like, or wants to work on a specific field which the professor is working on. Okay, that is an internship. But who is a project assistant or a project staff? A project assistant or a project staff is somebody who is qualified to be hired as manpower under a project. So that means that they have finished their undergraduate degree, they have some graduation degree to show in their application. Because a project assistant or a project associate, whoever might be the position, is still a more formal position as compared to an internship. So they need to be hired at least through a letter in the letterhead of the professor that is submitted to the institute. So for him to be hired, he should be qualified, right? So the qualification would be his undergraduate degree. So that is how a project assistant and an intern differs. But a person who is qualified can also be hired as an intern if a project assistant position is not available with a professor, like a professor who doesn't have much grants. So they can still work if the area that the professor is working on extremely hot or extremely interesting to you, and the professor says that he doesn't have funds to give you because he's working with only his PhD students, you can still go ahead and do an internship under him. So internship is most often an unpaid opportunity. A project assistant is most often a paid opportunity. So this difference you should understand. Now, how much will be the pay? So this is another question that people ask. So this is, each institute has their own pay structure clearly defined and approved by the Senate or Board of Directors of the institute. So let's say for IISc, a project assistant is somebody who has a graduation degree. So he gets paid 20,000 to 25,000 rupees. A project associate, on the other hand, is somebody who has an M.Tech degree. So he can expect to be paid around 28,000 or 30,000 rupees. And there are also research associates and research assistants. A research associate is most often a person who has completed a PhD degree. So they get at least up to 45,000 to 50,000 rupees. So there are different pay structures, just like the pay structure in the government. Okay, these have been well laid out, which is a very good idea, because there is no subjective nature in the pay structure, provided a professor agrees to pay you through his project. So even if the project, let's say, is granted by some government granting agency and there is a lot of money under the project, but a professor can pay you only as per the rules of the institute, even if the money is coming from another government body. You should understand that. So that pay structure is fixed. Okay, so I have talked to you about different kinds of ad hoc opportunities. These are still non-permanent contractual type opportunities that you can grab or make use of to move ahead to your next step in life, let's say a PhD or an M.Tech or a post graduation abroad. Okay, so what are the positions? There are internship positions, project associate, project assistantship positions. Okay, and internship positions are mostly unpaid, and mostly interns are those who are still doing their graduation, like let's say they are doing their major project with the lab, or they are doing the summer project with the lab. They are all interns. A project assistant is a much more formal position, mostly given to people who have completed their graduation. A project assistantship can be either paid or unpaid. If it is paid, it has to come through a project. So if you are choosing a professor, and if you are not in such a good financial position and you are hoping to get paid while working on your area of interest, you can look for professors who are actively applying for grants from granting agencies and who have active projects running in their labs. That would help you work in that lab in a much more comfortable manner, because you can also get paid. The bottom line is that you need to be able to convince the professor. You need to be confident of your own skills, what contribution you can provide to the lab, and how you can help the lab by improving itself, by improving its skill sets. So many often project assistants in labs which run a lot of projects, especially these funded projects, they are an important component in the lab. They are not treated, most of the they are somebody some people tell that project assistants are treated like second grade citizens in the lab. That is not true. Many of the in many of the labs, project assistants are a very strong component of how the lab functions, because they help the PhD students to work to do their work, because PhD students have to handle a lot of things. The project assistants, while they learn the tricks and trade of the domain which the professor is working on, they also contribute actively to the research in the lab by bringing in new knowledge. Let's say somebody has extremely good programming skills, which is not a core area of expertise in the lab, but that is required. So that project assistant will contribute very, very, very effectively and in a very good manner to the to how the lab progresses. You should understand that, yeah, in previous times there used to be this divide that you are a project assistant, I am a PhD student, I am an MTech student. That is no longer there, because research is extremely interdisciplinary now, and you need to have a good mix of people who have expertise in a different wide variety of domains. Even if you are doing experimental work, you need to know programming, you need to know application development, you need to know graphical user interface development, you need to know hardware development, you need to know packaging, you need to know manufacturing processes, so that you can finally think of making whatever you are working on as a final product. So project assistants in labs help in doing all these things while they gain knowledge from what is happening in the lab. So it's a win-win situation for everyone, the professor, his students, and the lab in general, and the project assistants who take back valuable information from the lab. Apart from that, as everybody knows, if the professor is happy with your work, he will be able to give you a recommendation letter which you can use for your further life, like applying for MS, Masters, PhD abroad or in Indian institutes. Okay, hope this has given you a good idea about these ad hoc positions that are there in IITs and IISCs. Choose wisely. Fundamentally, your decision should be based on what you want to work on and what your interests are. But if you have financial constraints, it's good that you look for professors who have projects, active projects from government agencies running, so that you can hope at least to get paid during your course of working. People usually spend around 1 to 2 years as project assistants in labs before they move on to their next step in life. Internships are mostly one-sided opportunities, like where the intern learns what is happening in the lab, and the professor can also showcase it as an outreach effort from his side, because he is fundamentally running a lab that is sponsored by the government. So it is his responsibility to educate as many youth as possible. So it's an opportunity for his outreach. And these students who come in as interns and project assistants do contribute in a very valuable manner to the progression of individual labs, and also in helping MTech and PhD students to do their work in a much more efficient manner. So it's a win-win situation. And if you did not know about these things, I hope this video has helped you. Cheers and good luck.